success of an interview is in the hands of the interviewer. It depends on how he planned and how he prepared his questions. Let us learn some lessons from the examples in this video.
Ms. Cruz, would you tell us something about child labor?
Oh, child labor. That's not good. I'm against that. Actually, I don't know how to answer your question.
In a radio interview, do not ask too broad or general questions. If you do, the interviewee may be confused and find it difficult to answer. Or, another possibility is that the interviewee will give you a lengthy answer.
Child labor is illegal employment of children under 18 years old in hazardous occupations. In our country, there are many children who are forced to do child labor because they need to support their parents in their daily lives. You know, many are poor here in the Philippines. Now there are 1 million children who are compelled to do manual labor. More than 2 million are exposed to hazardous works like mining, scavenging, prostitution, deep sea diving, fishing, and also quarrying. A lot of measures are being done right now, not only in the Philippines, but in other countries as well.
Is it true that smoking is bad for our health?
Yes.
And is it true that there are millions of chemicals in one stick of cigarette?
Yes.
And are you saying that smokers should quit smoking?
Yes, of course.
So do you advise smokers to quit smoking?
Yes, of course.
But is it easy to quit smoking?
Huh? No.
So you mean you cannot solve the problem of smoking?
No, I mean you're just wasting my time. Goodbye!
Poor interviewer. He wasted the opportunity to learn from the expert. Now, how can he use the interview when it contains really nothing?
Tell us, why is diarrhea dangerous to kids? And what should mothers do when the kids have diarrhea?
As soon as diarrhea starts, the child can be given more liquids or fluids to replace the liquid being lost and to prevent dehydration. The mother can give their babies breast milk and Older children can be given soups and thin lugaw, and also rehydration salts, fruit juices, and yes, weak tea. What was your first question again?
Since the interviewer asked two questions at a time, the interviewee was able to answer only the last question. He forgot about the first one. Sometimes an interviewee may be able to answer all the questions, but imagine how long will the answer be. Would you like to bore the listener?
That is how I felt.
Wait, let's start the interview. Before the show, we were talking about the terrorist attacks in the World Trade Center and the Pentagon, and you were saying that you were at the vicinity of the World Trade Center when it happened. So what was your reaction?
Right, I told you how I felt. Until now, I can't believe that happened to me.
Ideally, the interviewer must converse with the interviewee before airtime. This will put the interviewee at ease and the areas of questioning may be established. However, during the interview, never refer to conversations that took place before airtime.
We've been hearing rumors lately that you've been having an affair with someone. How true is this?
Huh?
Remember, you have to help your interviewee feel relaxed and comfortable so that he will be encouraged to talk more. Hence, if you must ask about personal matters, delay it until about the end of the interview. Those were some tips on how to ask questions in a radio interview. think about them and practice using the tips next time that you do an interview.